Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. The Starlink 35 mission was delayed from Tuesday to today, but has been delayed again until tomorrow. The Starlink 35 mission is now scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 27th at 1:40pm UTC or 9:40am EDT. Coming up later in the day tomorrow, we can hopefully expect to see the next Falcon Heavy mission lift off as well. The Falcon Heavy Viasat-3 and Aurora 4A mission is scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 27th at 11:29pm UTC or 7:29pm EDT. In addition, SpaceX is still planning to launch another mission a little later in the week. The O3B Empower 3 and 4 mission is still scheduled for Friday 28th at 9:12pm UTC or 5:12pm EDT. There was a tweet posted related to the Viasat-3 mission. It says, SpaceX recovery ship Doug is almost 1700 kilometers downrange and still going from LC-39A to recover the fairing halves for the upcoming Falcon Heavy Viasat-3 mission. If successful, the recovered fairings would hold the record for the furthest downrange distance. All three Falcon cores will be expended. Per NSF forums, the side boosters will land 770 kilometers downrange and the center core 1880 kilometers. I want to say congrats to Thomas Burchart, formerly part of NASA spaceflight, for getting a job at SpaceX. He said, "Happy to announce that today was my first day as a SpaceX launch engineer at SLC-4. SpaceX appear to be leasing another launch pad at Vandenberg Space Force Base. Jack Beyer posted this tweet saying Vandenberg's SLC-6 will live on. It's being leased by SpaceX. SpaceX have got another Falcon Heavy launch, with Astrobotics posting this tweet. It says we are heading to the moon's south pole again in 2026. Today at the Lunar Surface Innovation Consortium, we announced our purchase, launch services aboard a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket for our third upcoming lunar lander mission. Heading to Boca Chica, as we saw last episode, the orbital launch mount is a mess after Thursday's launch of Starship. Since the Starship launch, SpaceX had not moved the chopsticks at all and there was concern there could be an issue. However, SpaceX recently moved the chopsticks, meaning they are probably good. Seems the tower held up pretty well. SpaceX posted this super cool picture of the immense super heavy booster flame. They said, the world's most powerful launch vehicle ever developed. As always, I have to say thanks to Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.